She came right out of that really thick. she was standing right there. So I was shooting, you know, this stuff here, this, you know, it's a pretty clumsy brush, but that looked like she turned and went straight through there, but I'm not seeing any blood right away here. Just judging by the sound of the impact, and I kind of replayed it in my mind what I thought happened, and the sound, it sounded a little paunchy, didn't have that pop like you want to hear, and then looking at the color of the blood, I'm pretty confident that it's a liver shot. We're going to go back, like I said, she's going to need some time anyway. You know, I hate it when that happens, but that's, you know, that's the nature of it. It doesn't always go as you would hope it would. And, you know, we hate to, as sportsmen, we hate to have things like this happen, but the brutal reality of it is it does happen, so. So, unfortunately, that sound right there, not what I wanted to hear. Came out here just before dark, see if we could at least find blood. And I walked all up and down the fence line where I think she crossed, and then some, and I cannot find any blood trail. And we're not allowed to go in Iowa. You're allowed to pursue your game and retrieve it. However, there's no blood trail to follow, so we can't just go wandering around our neighbor's property. And where that coyote was just letting loose is about where I think she went. You know, it's unfortunate, but that's just kind of, you know, you do this long enough and, you know, I've lost two deer so far in my life, once last year and once this year, and this one was 100% my fault. You know, I shot a little bit high and a little bit back, and that's, you know, unfortunately, I mean, she's dead. There's no doubt in my mind. However, when it's that high on their body, they don't bleed much. You know, we get a lot of people ask questions, you know, let me see the blood trail from your broadheads. Well, it's not necessarily the broadhead. If you have a lower exit, you're going to get more blood, you know, as long as it doesn't fill up with, you know, entrails or whatever. You know, if you got a good sharp broadhead that exits in the lower half of their body, you're going to get a blood trail. It's just all there is to it. And unfortunately, this one was a little high. 100% my fault, and I feel horrible about it, but like I said, this is, you know, you do this long enough and something like this is going to happen. So probably going to take a couple of days off. This weekend I'm going down to Arkansas to film a hunt for Veteran Creed Outdoors. We've got a first responder coming in, and I was hoping to take some deer steaks down there with me. That was kind of my intention. You know, I still got some more tags to fill, and tonight I'm going to go ahead and punch one of them. You know, I know I killed that deer. There's no doubt in my mind. Just unfortunately, I wasn't able to recover. But that's just the name of the game. Okay, so I'm out here on the porch picking stick tights. Carter and I went back out and looked for a couple more hours under the lights, get a different perspective, and unfortunately we didn't find anything. I want to reiterate my comment about the broadheads in comparison to your blood trails. You know, 90% of the time, if not more, the type of blood trail you're going to get is largely dependent on where your arrow comes out of that animal. You know, if it's down in the brisket area where it comes out, you're probably not going to get a lot of blood because it'll get clogged up with fat. If you're a little far back and low, you'll get entrails. You know, if you get right in that 12 ring, you know, right through the heart, you know, above the brisket, you're likely to get a really good blood trail. You get, you know, it's on the bottom half of that animal, their chest cavity doesn't have to fill up before it starts pouring out the hole, which is, I'm pretty sure, what happened to me today. That animal has to bleed a lot before the blood's going to come out of that hole, out of that exit hole. You know, and if you don't get a pass through, you know, your blood trail is going to be even less. So yeah, super late. I got to get up for work in the morning. Carter's got school when he came out, and oh geez, we was digging deep trying to find anything we could, and just nothing to be found. And, you know, I kind of pride myself on, you know, being able to recover my animals, and you know, even tracking their prints if I have to, and broken twigs, and it just wasn't anything. It was a tough one. Hard pill for me to swallow. I'm really disappointed in myself. And so, yep, my tag's already punched, and I know without a doubt that I killed that animal, just wasn't able to recover it. You know, it's real disappointing for me. But I've got some more tags, and got a whole lot of season left to hunt, and you know, I've got some exciting things coming up, and both the boys got tags to fill yet, and we're just gonna take a couple days off and dust myself off and get back out there. So, all right, y'all have a good season.